just the beginning of a long career. It's more about two characters that are living at the opposite end of the international spectrum, but they're also living on the opposite side of the border that divides Hong Kong and China. And I also think that the movie is a very, is also about Hong Kong, and it's a very special look on the city. I just wanted to start the conversation by asking you all, you know, how you came to make a movie, this particular movie,
sure,
this subject.
I think because I grew up in Hong Kong and the city is always changing. When I was growing up, a lot of people are leaving the city. I mean, Toronto being one of the most populous place to move to. And now that I've been back, and it's changed a lot, and it's now a city where people are moving into. So I wanted to capture the really what is going on right now, and I think there are different perspectives in Hong Kong, and some people sort of think of Hong Kong as a place that is deteriorating, that has lost its past glory, and other people think of it as a place of hope. So I wanted to put these two characters together.
So how did you manage to cast to have Felina Lau and Chang Gong starring in the first feature film? I think that's pretty impressive.
Yeah, that was really lucky actually. I was very lucky to find my two very good producers who introduced me to my actors. I've always wanted to work with them, so I was lucky that they liked the script.
If you have questions for Flora, please raise your hand. We'll try and spot you.
Yes, some of them. The part that some street locations are shown in China.
Other question. Sorry, if it's difficult for us to see you because we have the light right on our eyes. So if you have questions, just speak up. Yes, please.
It's mainly based on my feeling of Hong Kong. I really just started from what I feel about Hong Kong and just trying to find different people and their feelings of Hong Kong and just listening to the stories, just meeting the people who are trying to get across the border and meeting other people that inspired me. I think the fast pace of Hong Kong does have that effect on people. And Hong Kong has gone through a lot of changes politically and economically, so there's some sort of desperation, I think, in people's daily lives. Yeah, I think, because I think that Hong Kong is also quite a sort of segregated place for the rich and the poor. So I wanted to have these two perspectives and to sort of show people a different perspective and to share their journey. So ultimately, I think that under all these desperation and despair, there's similar emotions that these people go through. Well, there's a one-child policy in China, and which means that you can only have one child, and if you have more, you have to pay for your second child. But if your child is born outside of China, that then it doesn't count as your second child, because the other child will get residency for another country. And Hong Kong is a special place because it's under Chinese government, but it's a special administrative region, which means that we don't, our laws are different, so we don't have that one child policy. They can return back home, but the second child will not be a China citizen. It will be a Hong Kong citizen. It's a little bit different, but you know, that's why a lot of people come to Hong Kong to give birth, because it's the closest place where you can do that. I think a lot of these people live there sort of underground. They don't really, they're not really recognized by the government, so they cannot really go to the same school that other people go to. So yeah, a lot of problems. It will be shown in November. We're hoping that it will.
Yes,
I mean, I think I wanted to show deep down how lonely these characters are, even though Hong Kong is a really fast-paced city and people are always doing things. And I think a lot of films also try to capture that of Hong Kong, the fast-paced, the tall buildings. I wanted to show sort of a different side, which is where she lives is actually pretty quiet. And yeah, in terms of the pacing and the picture, I wanted to show sort of cinematically how they feel. So how they feel would be that kind of, you know, desolate kind of image. For me, it's a journey that she takes, and because at the end she sort of has a breakdown, I think that she is a sign of the next beginning for her. So I think for me the journey ends with her there, realizing, you know, what her past means to her and what her future lies. So yeah, I think it's your imagination what's going to happen to her.
Yes?
Can you explain the where you got the English title ends from and how or why that is different from what I thought was the Chinese title? The Chinese thing is that.
The Chinese title actually means to cross the border. But I wanted, but to name it Cross the Border sounds a bit weird in English. I think the idea of bands actually came from the border that Hong Kong and China has. We are separated by a river. It's actually a really small river that's really bendy. So whenever I pass the border to go to China, I see that river. And that has a huge impact on me and the story, so I ended up naming it Benz, which is the bands.
We have time for one last question, so let's see.
I think because she's after she realized that there's something wrong, that her husband is not there, that her, the world that she believes in or is used to is breaking down in front of her. So she needed something to latch on. And Hong Kong being quite a superstitious place, it's easy to go down that road and just sort of to latch on that to sort of find her way back rather than actually practically going out and find a solution.
Unfortunately, we have to wrap to close to finish our discussion here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.